Hello all, I am Dr. Karthik Balasubramanian, scientist at Agarkar Research Institute. Today we are going to discuss about some wonderful group of organism called diatom. Before getting into about the organism which we are going to discuss, I just want to introduce all my institute, which is Agarkar Research Institute, which was started by Professor S.P. Agarkar in 1946. Our institute is a grand autonomous institute by Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. In our institute, we work at six different thematic areas, such as biodiversity, bioenergy, bioprospecting, developmental biology, genetics and plant breeding, and nanobioscience. And one of the unique thing about our institute is our repository, which holds national fungal collections, and we have 60-70-year-old herbarium of plants as well as lichens, and we have the one of the country's biggest fossil repository, and we also have microbial culture collection, which is specially focusing on anaerobic microorganisms. So the organism which I am going to talk today, the diatoms, are microscopic organism. So in this picture we have the arrangement of a very tiny virus of 0.45 nanometer to human hair, you will see on the right. So in this highlight area, you can see 5 to 90 micron objects are highlighted, starting from red blood cells to fine beach sand. This is the range of a diatom. This is the approximate range of a diatom, which will be 7-8 micron to 100 micron. That's what we are going to talk. And when we come to different types of microorganism, starting from virus, bacteria, protozoa, fungi, and then there is another huge group of microorganism called algae. So algae are mostly microscopic plants, so they fix carbon dioxide and produce using light and water, they produce oxygen and then some storage material. On your left, you are seeing a morphological diversity of algae. In this, I am just highlighting two algae, which are called as diatom. We will be talking about diatom in detail today. Diatoms are a base of aquatic food chains. So what you are seeing here in this picture are diatoms which occurs as single cells or colonies in different aquatic environment, and they are the primary producer in any given aquatic ecosystem. All other insects and small fishes, they eat diatoms and they depend on the diatoms for their food. So, and one of the special feature of diatoms are they are made up of silica. So in this picture, in this smiley, you are seeing eyes, this is a different species. In nose, there are different species. And then in the a mouth, you are seeing a different species. So they are all made up of silica cell wall. So that's why diatoms are often called as life in glass house. So the entire cell is inside this glass house. So when we try to elaborate the cell structure of diatom, they are comparable to a soap box or a petri dish. So if we take a soap box, we have a lid and we have a base, and inside we keep the soap. So diatoms are also made similarly. So there is a lid and then there is a base. So inside this, the cell organelles are present. So you have on the left side, you are seeing the lid, and then on the right side, you are seeing the base of the soap box. So where do diatom live? Diatom live in any water bodies, or even sometimes where there are little moisture out there. So they can live in fresh water, salt water, up to deep marine, and then they can live in ice and hot springs, boiling hot springs. So they live in a variety of environment, but only particular environment have a particular set of species. For example, the organisms which are living in freshwater, they cannot live in a salt water, or organisms which are living in cold condition, they cannot live in a warm or a hot condition. So they are very specific to their environment. And the picture on my left, you can see a tadpole eating a diatom grown on a stone. So that makes that they are the base of food chain. Interestingly, diatoms can also live in some unique habitat. For example, in this picture, you are seeing a different species of marine turtles. So there are some diatom, they are specific to the back of the turtle. They grow only on the back of a turtle. So there is some school project where students documented types of diatom growing on the turtle. In river, where we will see diatom. So for example, if we go to a river, we pick a stone. The stone is filled with brown color growth. So here, I'm just playing this video, so you can see using a toothbrush, we remove the biofilm, brown color biofilm grown on the diatom. So you can see that's what we are removing from the and whatever we have removed, when we look under the microscope, this would be a whole new world altogether. You can see here there are diatoms, you know, different types of diatoms mixed with other microorganism, and then some microscopic invertebrates, and then a whole array of plants and animals are here. This is comparable to a ecosystem of a forest. So what you are seeing here, you are seeing different plants and then different animals. So what we are seeing in under the microscope, which is comparable to that. So it's a set of or array of microorganism, insects, etc. are living in this condition. So they are thriving in a condition where they are the prey, and they also have a predator. In this video, you are seeing a zooplankton which goes and hunt and eat all the diatoms which are available in their environment. You can see this this microinvertebrate, the zooplankton, goes and feeds on diatoms, or like the entire group of algae growing in that particular environment. So how do we study diatom? We collect the biofilm, as I mentioned earlier. So we have the biofilm here, we bring it, and then we want to see the silica structure. As I mentioned before, we want to see the silica structure. So to see the silica structure, we boil the diatoms, collected diatom samples, with nitric acid. In the nitric acid, all the organic material will get oxidized, and then we will be able to see a clean diatom samples. So when once we clean the diatom and they look like this on your left, you are seeing it's a microscopic view at 100x. So we are seeing different species of diatom there. You can see like spindle shaped, oval shaped, and then boat shaped, and some are like lengthy, like a ladder kind of shapes are there. So there are many species of diatoms are there in this particular sample. So here we are making a list of species in this sample. So what are all the different species are there? Based on this, what are the species are there, we will be able to see whether this water is clean water or moderately polluted water or very dirty water. So using diatoms, we will know what are the kinds of pollution there in a particular river, and how do we can restore the river. So this screenshot which I am presenting here is from a software called SimRiver project. If you type diatom project in the Google, you will land on this project called Simulator River. And while we do this, we also encounter many new species of diatoms. up to today, we have described more than 60 new species of datum from different part of India. In India, H.P. Gandhi described more than 300 new species from different part of Western India. Globally, Linnaeus have described more than 7,000 species. I think 7,000 in even only in one particular publication. So, in Japan, we try to see compare different diatom at different environment. In Japan, there are this is the condition of Japan in 1916, which has been moved to the rivers has been restored, and it is looking like this today. And our 1960s rivers were looking very clean, and then today it is filled with lot of pollution and things like that. So if we think this is has been revealed by diatom, so if we compare the our 1960s diatom in our rivers is comparable to the clean river diatoms of Japan. So if we think, we can reverse and restore our rivers back to the original condition. Apart from this, diatoms also give one of the invaluable ecosystem service. Diatom produce oxygen. So diatom produce almost 1/4 of oxygen. That is 24% of global oxygen is produced by diatom, which means every fourth breath which we take, the oxygen come exclusively from diatoms. So we have to be thankful to diatom on every day, because diatoms are helpful for sustaining of us humans and many other animals. And diatoms have a big connection with the Nobel Prize. Alfred Nobel made the dynamite using diatomaceous earth, which gave a lot of money to the Nobel Foundation. So which is supporting the Nobel Prize every year. So diatoms are also support, diatoms give a huge support to global research. Apart from these services, diatom also provide medical pharmaceutical supplements in form of omega-3 fatty acid. There are also biofuel production from diatom, and diatoms are used as a template for many nanotechnological applications. So I wish to thank my funding agencies for supporting the research, and my students who have done all this, most of the work here, and my institute for supporting. I want to conclude my talk with a statement: if you can read, thank your teacher. If you can breathe, thank the diatom. Thank you.